Antes de mais, quero agradecer à Escola Náutica este convite e dar os parabéns por essa iniciativa, por um seminário internacional em inglês e, portanto, termos várias pessoas de vários países estarem presentes. É um grande prazer saber que estamos a ter esta iniciativa e, ainda por cima, numa questão que tem a ver com o futuro e tem a ver com novas tecnologias. Eu vou falar em inglês porque acho que é a língua que todos falamos e, portanto, a partir de agora vou passar a fazer a minha breve apresentação em inglês. So, good morning to all. I'm Pedro Galvão from the Portuguese Shippers Council. So, I'll try to give you some ideas of what we think and how we see the future regarding the digital transition. And I will just touch, let's say, 4 points, and then I will take some conclusions. The 4 points basically are what is new and what is not new, what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages, and finally the conclusions. What is not new is these platforms, and I was listening to George Almeida, and it was in fact him who for the first time talked to me about this project of digital platforms in order to trade and to charter vessels. That was already, I don't know, 15 years ago. It was still a long time ago. And at that time, as you just mentioned, it did not work, but it was a good attempt. At that moment, we studied the project. I, besides being the chairman of the Portuguese Shippers Council, I'm also an executive from Cecil, as you've seen on my CV. So it is a cement company, and we charter vessels for solid fuels and for cement. That did not work. So at that time, it was an attempt. It is not new, but it did not work. But now we have a new environment. So and this is different from what happened 15 years ago, and it is also mentioned. We had a new situation, which is the major challenge. The pandemic is the major challenge, but it gives us also a lot of opportunities. And one of the opportunities is that, as we just listened, we start to get used to new technologies like the one we are using at this moment, and we get used to this. Not only us, which are for older generations, but basically for the younger generations. We see kids with 15, 12 years old getting used to this kind of tools, which we did not knew a few years ago. Or a few months ago. So we have a new environment, not only in terms of culture, people are much more open to these new technologies, but also it is also new, the equipment, both for the hardware, but also the software. So we have more tools today, and the culture is much more open to these new types of communication and trying to find ways of doing things in a different manner. So we say if we have the new environment, new tools, why are not we using this new equipment and these new advantages? And we come to the advantages. I've seen the presentation on the number of trades involved in the whole world for chartering, and also the amount of money who goes to the brokerage position, because basically one of the major savings for this project would be on saving. Of course, there is efficiency, but there is also some brokerage fees, which are calculated at $14 billion for this type of activity on an annual basis. So this will be the advantages of a platform or using e-shipping would be cost reduction, I would say more transparency, and overall cutting costs. So this is clearly, those are advantages which we can foresee. However, in my point of view, there are also some disadvantages. So brokers are not only people who try to find buyers and sellers, charterers and ship owners. Brokers, if they are good brokers, they also solve problems. They present some solutions when there are problems. Their expertise, it's sometimes very useful to solve and overcome some problems. Secondly, on finding some contracts which are difficult to negotiate, we have contracts, charter partners with 20 pages, and we know that the clauses sometimes are difficult to negotiate. And thirdly, we also have buy from a broker. Normally, if it's a good professional, we also get from him a lot of information, which is relevant, of course, in terms of our daily business. So it's not just, let's say, finding a buyer and a seller. If we're talking about a good broker, especially on the bulk business as we are operating at the moment, and that we know better, we have a lot of information, a lot of service. So we pay for this service, and we get it, of course. So what we would like to know is if there is will be or not, and as a conclusion, there will be or not possibilities of using these tools, this e-shipping or these digital equipments or platforms in order to improve our business as a whole. So I'm optimistic. I'm optimistic because if we can make a trial and we can in somehow standardize our operations, we will be able to solve or to tackle some problems like having different types of contract. We know that there are different types of charter parties. We can, in some trades, normalize and try to have an access to the information. So that can be done, and I think it's a very good opportunity to try on making an experiences and see how things are going. I believe also that with the container business much more specialized and standardized, it's much easier to implement these kind of tools. But as I said, having a new generation and having a school like INIT involved in this process, of course, it will be very, very useful to make this project to go forward. I would like just to conclude that although this digitalization is an important, I believe that there are other major, in my point of view, issue which is on the table today, which should concern, it's a concern for us all, which is CO2 emissions. Engineer Castro from Port of Sines has mentioned, we are going through a process of decarbonization, which is already taking several impacts on our country in Portugal, and of course in all over the world. just in January this year, we stopped one power plant, which was considered about 10% of the volume of the Port of Sines, was shut down. So 10%, it's a lot. It's close to 5 million tons in some years. So this has an impact in terms of usage of the port, of the volume. Something like is happening also in Leixões, the port of Leixões, by closing down a refinery. Those are huge investments, employing a lot of people. And of course, they will have a big impact on our ports. And those two are related with energy, and those two are related with carbon or the consequences of CO2 emissions. It is not the only one. Other industries are directly involved, especially the ones which have very much related to energy. They also will have an impact on the coming years. We all know that IMO has already set a target of 40% of emissions, CO2 emissions, by 2030. And the zero emissions will be a target that we should all have in our hands. And I believe that this is the major concern for us all in the next few years. Unfortunately, we do not see a lot of discussion about this matter, but I believe that this will be sooner much sooner than we expect, one of our major concerns. We know already that there is a project for having implemented by January of 2023 the Energy Efficiency Design Index that will measure the efficiency of the ships. That will be mandatory. That will be decided next month by June 2021. This will be the first, it will be the beginning by having all the ships certified in terms of efficiency. This will be the one of the steps other who are being taken, but for sure we will have to have this in mind. How does digitalization has an impact on emissions, on CO2? I think that could be a good help. One way or another, digitalization, ports, ships, and the whole industry will be very, very helpful on this target of being a more friendly, environmental friendly industry, which of course we will have to deal with it in the coming years. Okay, and this is what I have to share with you. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr.